Namaskar, good evening. You are watching Rajya Sabha Television. I'm Smriti Rastogi with News Tonight. Let's begin the bulletin with the top headlines. Prime Minister Narendra Modi reviews progress of his government's flagship schemes in a meeting of the Council of Ministers. Union Cabinet clears 24,000 crore rupees FDI for HDFC Bank, approves dam safety bill for proper operation and maintenance of dams across the country. Enforcement Directorate files charge sheet against Karthi Chidambaram, also names former Finance Minister P. Chidambaram. Agency alleges firms controlled by Karthi received over 1 crore rupees in bribe in ASL Max's deal. BSF calls Pakistani firing along the international border betrayal, says the country never maintained the sanctity of the ceasefire. Four BSF personnel, including an assistant commandant, killed, five others injured in firing in Sabha district last night. Former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee's health shows significant improvement, with doctors hoping for his full recovery soon. The 93-year-old leader was admitted to AIIMS, Delhi on Monday for urinary tract infection. An Afghanistan cricket team to make its debut in Test cricket on Thursday will take on world number one, India, in its inaugural match at M. Chinnaswamy Stadium in Bengaluru. Prime Minister Narendra Modi reviewed the progress of his government's flagship schemes as well as took stock of the economic progress at a meeting of the Council of Ministers on Wednesday. Among the prominent flagship schemes that were reviewed include Pradhan Mantri Jan Aushadhi Yojana, Ayushman Bharat, Pradhan Mantri Fasal Bima Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana, Startup Funding Scheme and Mudra Yojana. The meeting took up the agenda The meeting also took up the agenda for the last year of the current NDA rule. Besides, the meeting also discussed issues like farmer distress and the government's efforts to provide relief to them through various initiatives announced in the budget, like 1.5 times higher minimum support price to farmers than the cost of the production. The meeting was held in Parliament House. All ministers were also present in the crucial meeting. The Union Cabinet, chaired by Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Wednesday, took various key decisions. The Cabinet has cleared the HDFC Bank's proposal to raise 24,000 crore rupees via FDI. It has also approved repositioning of Northeastern Council and proposal for enactment of Dam Safety Bill 2018. Details in this report.
In the cabinet meeting held on Wednesday, the government gave approval to HDFC Bank to raise 24,000 crore rupees in foreign direct investment to fund its business growth. The move is expected to further strengthen the banking system and is also an important step in foreign investment.
HDFC Bank mein 24,000 crore rupay ka additional FDI, adhik foreign direct investment, approved kiya gaya hai.
Meanwhile, the meeting chaired by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi also approved reconstitution of Northeastern Council. The Cabinet has decided to bring the Council under the direct control of the Home Ministry. The Council will help in the development of the Northeastern region.
Mananiya Pradhan Mantri Ji ke agre pe Cabinet ne ye nirnay liya ke ab desh ke Mananiya Grah Mantri Northeastern Council ki adhyakshata karenge as ex officio chairperson. और जो डोनर मंत्री होंगे वो उसके वाइस चेयरमैन रहेंगे.
The Cabinet has also approved the proposal for introduction of Dam Safety Bill 2018 in the Parliament. It will help all the states and union territories to adopt uniform dam safety procedures to ensure safety of dams.
Dam Safety Bill 2018 इसको आज मंजूरी दी गई प्रधानमंत्री श्री नरेंद्र मोदी जी के अध्यक्षता में कैबिनेट द्वारा.
The government has also approved the continuation of 3-year action plan of the scheme for Agricultural Education Division and ICAR institutes with an outlay of 2,225 crore rupees. The move is aimed at strengthening higher education in agriculture.
Education Division और ICAR के इंस्टीट्यूट्स के लिए 2017 से 20 इस समय अवधि में 2225 करोड़ रुपए की लागत से ये सभी जो एग्रीकल्चरल एजुकेशन इंस्टीट्यूशंस हैं वो कैसे उनको और अच्छी तरीके से शिक्षा फार्म क्षेत्र में एग्रीकल्चर क्षेत्र में शिक्षा देने के लिए मजबूत बनाया जाए, कैसे अच्छे लोगों को तैयार किया जाए एग्रीकल्चर के क्षेत्र में जो आगे चल के उच्च शिक्षा भी पाए एग्रीकल्चर एजुकेशन में और नई नई टेक्नोलॉजी नए इनिशिएटिव्स को देश भर में हम ले जा सकें, इसके लिए इन इंस्टीट्यूट्स को और मजबूत करने की योजना बनाई गई है।
The Union Cabinet also approved a proposal for leasing out 3.7 acres of land at Pragati Maidan to a private player for construction of a hotel. Panchanand Mishra's report for Rajya Sabha TV.
And for more on this, we'll go across to our correspondent Panchanand Mishra, who is joining us live from the newsroom. Panchanand, give us some details about the major decisions that were taken by the Cabinet meeting today.
There was a Cabinet meeting in Parliament around 4 p.m. and some major decisions were taken, and this decision involves the FDI. As we have just mentioned in our report, that 24,000 crore FDI will be brought in the HDFC Bank, and there will be it will be under the cap of 74% of FDI norm, and it will boost this the proposal from HDFC Bank to the stature of the this bank, and FDI will certainly provide a better environment in the functioning of the bank and banking sector. And apart from this, the repositioning of this Northeastern Council is also very important, because till now it was chaired by this North Donier Ministry, but now the Home Minister will be ex officio chairman, and the North Donier Minister will be the vice chairman. And this is done due to the functioning will be a very good because there is a center and state relations are involved in particularly with respect to this Northeast regions. So the Home Ministry, if there is a chairman from Home Minister chairman, then it will be very much easier, and also the coordination will be better for the functioning of the Northeastern state. Because government has now always giving a major thrust to the Northeastern state, so it will be a better. And another important thing is that there was a bill related to dam safety, because it was stuck since 2002. But the government is bringing now a specific and particular bill for the dam safety, and it will ensure the it will apply to the all over coordination between states and the center for the safety of the dams, because absolutely, there are more than 5,000 dams in the country, and there needs to be a uniform bill for the safety and also the structure of the dams. So these are some major, apart from some smaller decisions these are taken. The major decisions has been taken in Union Cabinet.
Panchanand, the Prime Minister also held a review meeting of his government's flagship scheme today. Why this meeting was called, and what has come out of the review of the various ministries? Can you tell us about that?
The Council of Ministers meeting is a regular phenomena in a month time, but this meeting was not held since last 3 months. And in these last 3 months, there were so many events happened, like many elections where the BJP has lost, and the like in Uttar Pradesh and in Karnataka. So certainly there was the mind of Prime Minister that now it has to be done. The schemes has to be you can say it has to be progressed in such a way that it can the fruits of the schemes can reach up to a common man. So there was a consensus that the schemes will be now propagated in such a way that it will reach up to a common man. That was the basically agenda. And now the forthcoming schemes like Ayushman Bharat, which is expected to be implemented from the 15th of August, that there was a major discussion on that. And also the schemes, the ongoing schemes like Mudra schemes and the Fasal Bima Yojana, which were also a point of major discussions between the Council of Ministers. So there was a total assessment, and also the better implementation was on the agenda for this Council of Ministers meet. Smriti.
Panchanand, did Prime Minister say anything specifically about any ministry if they are required to improve their performance?
Yes, I just mentioned that Ayushman Bharat was a focus, because government is thinking that it may be a game changer in the coming time. And the Lok Sabha elections, as they are approaching in 9 to 10 months, So the major thrust is being put on these social schemes which the government is now running, and the Mudra scheme is also because the government is now claiming that it has 12 crore beneficiaries of Mudra loan, and it has to be propagated well in the society and the common man. So this was the these were the social schemes were the point of agenda, and it was discussed well.
Thank you
and
so much,
Panchanan. The focus was that we have to propagate it to the people.
Thank you so much, Panchanan, for giving us all those details. And of course, the social schemes were the important agenda which was discussed in the Council of Ministers meeting which was held with Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And on to some more developments. Pakistan has betrayed India once again. Days after, flag meetings were held between the BSF and the Pakistan Rangers, where the two agreed to maintain ceasefire along the border. Unprovoked firing from across the border claimed the lives of four BSF personnel on Tuesday night. Details of the latest incident in this report.
Four Border Security Force personnel, including an assistant commandant rank officer, were killed and three others injured in firing by Pakistan Rangers along the international border in Samba district of Jammu and Kashmir. The BSF said Pakistan resorted to unprovoked firing and betrayed India by not honouring its commitment made at the recent DGMO level talks.
Since the ceasefire was on, that is the time we used to strengthen our defences, and a team was going with the defence material. Pakistan violated the ceasefire, fired at them with flak trajectory weapon, followed by mortar firing. And that's how the casualty has taken place.
The BSF ADG also said that Indian forces have maintained the sanctity of the ceasefire along the frontier, accusing Pakistan of violating the truce deal yet again. He added that the BSF would lodge a protest with the Pakistani side over the incident.
Ceasefire is always a bilateral decision. There was a meeting between our sector DIGs and the counterpart designated to hold this meeting. And there it was decided that there will be ceasefire. We have maintained the sanctity of ceasefire. Pakistan has not. It has violated it. We are only concerned about such a gross violation of ceasefire where the meeting took place on their request. For us, the main concern is lack of credibility in their request for ceasefire.
Jammu and Kashmir Chief Minister Mehbooba Mufti, as well as state units of the Congress and BJP, expressed anguish and grief over the killing of BSF personnel in cross-border firing.
Our soldiers are the ones who give their mouth to their mouth. Our soldiers have been opened with open hands that when पाकिस्तान तीन जो हमारी जंग हुई उसमें तो जीत नहीं लग सका, लेकिन छदम युद्ध छेड़ करके ये जो कोल्ड वार है ये इस करता है.
As many as 11 BSF personnel have been killed in cross-border firing incidents along the international border in Jammu and Kashmir till date in 2018. This is the highest casualty figure for the border force in a year in the last 5 years. Bureau report, Rajya Sabha TV.
On to some more news. The Enforcement Directorate has filed a charge sheet in a Delhi court against Karthi Chidambaram and others in the ASL Max's money laundering case. Today's charge sheet, which is a part of the 2G spectrum allocation case, has been filed against Karthi Chidambaram, Advantage Strategic Consultancies Private Limited, Chess Management Services Private Limited and a few others under the Prevention of Money Laundering Act. ED has also mentioned former Union Minister and Congress leader P. Chidambaram in the charge sheet. The ED claimed in its charge sheet that Karthi Chidambaram controlled two firms, Advantage Strategic Consultancies Private Limited and Chess Management Services Private Limited, which allegedly received 1.16 crore rupees as bribe money in the ASL Max's money laundering case. The agency has questioned and recorded the statement of Karthi Chidambaram in this case at least twice. The agency told the court that it might file a supplementary charge sheet in the case. The Enforcement Directorate also questioned P. Chidambaram for the second time in this case on Tuesday. Prime Minister Narendra Modi will visit Chhattisgarh on Thursday. He is scheduled to inaugurate modernized and expanded Bhilai steel plant. He is also expected to lay the foundation stone of a permanent IIT Bhilai campus and unveil a plaque to mark the launch of the phase 2 of the BharatNet. The Prime Minister will inaugurate air services between Jagdalpur and Raipur. Before reaching Bhilai, Prime Minister Modi will visit Naya Raipur Smart City, where he will inaugurate the Integrated Command and Control Center for the city. And doctors at AIIMS are hopeful as former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee has shown significant improvement in the last 48 hours. Doctors have said that the infection is under control and the blood pressure, respiratory function and the heart rate are also normal. The 93-year-old leader was admitted to the hospital on Monday morning with urinary tract infection.
अच्छी इम्प्रूवमेंट हुई है उनके इन्फेक्शन भी कंट्रोल में आया है और उनका यूरिन आउटपुट भी इम्प्रूव हुआ है और अभी वो उनका ब्लड प्रेशर ब्रीदिंग रेट हार्ट रेट्स सब नॉर्मल हैं और वो बिना किसी सपोर्ट के चल रहा है उनके लैब पैरामीटर्स भी जो जांच आज रिपोर्ट आई है वो नॉर्मल है और हम ये उम्मीद करते हैं कि कुछ दिन में वो बिल्कुल स्वस्थ हो जाएंगे और हम उनको घर भेज पाएंगे
And with that, time for a very short break. More news and updates on the other side. Stay with us.
Watch The Big Picture with me, Frank Rausen Pereira, at 9:30 p.m.
Welcome back. PhD has been made mandatory for recruitment of teachers in universities from 2021 to 22. Announcing the new regulations of the University Grants Commission, HRD Minister Prakash Javarekar said on Wednesday that cracking the national eligibility test would not be accepted as the only eligibility criteria. However, master's degree with NET or PhD would continue to be the minimum eligibility criteria for direct recruitment in colleges. Indian students who got their PhD degree from top 500 universities abroad will also be eligible for appointment in universities. At present, those who hold PhD degree or are NET qualified with master's degree are eligible to apply for the post of assistant professor, which is the entry level position in universities.
पहली दफा कॉलेज में प्रोफेसर नहीं होते थे, केवल असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर होते थे। अब कॉलेज में प्रोफेसर भी प्रमोशन होकर प्रोफेसर बनेंगे, ये पहली दफा पहल की है। स्तर बड़ा करने के लिए अब प्रमोशन के लिए पीएचडी आवश्यक बनाया गया है और रिक्रूटमेंट के लिए भी असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर के पद पर आने के लिए भी पीएचडी रहेगा जरूरी, लेकिन वो अभी तुरंत नहीं कर सकते क्योंकि सभी अभी नहीं है। तो 2021 से 3 साल की मोहलत दी है, तो 18, 19, 20, 21 3 साल है तो रिसर्च प्रोजेक्ट होता है, तो वो पीएचडी करके ही फिर जॉब में आ सकेंगे।
And now the news from Karnataka, where the Congress won Jayanagar Assembly seat by a margin of more than 2,800 votes. Congress's Soumya Reddy secured 54,457 votes, while BJP's B.N. Prahlad secured 51,568 votes. Congress now has 80 seats in the Assembly. Polling on Jayanagar seat was postponed due to the death of BJP candidate B.N. Vijay Kumar, and the by-poll was held on 11th June. The JDS did not field any candidate in the contest and extended its support to the Congress. This was the first election after the JDS-Congress combined came to power in the state, in which they put up a united fight against the BJP. And the Congress President Rahul Gandhi held the iftar party on Wednesday after a gap of 2 years. It was Rahul Gandhi's first iftar event after taking over the reins of the party. Former Presidents Pranab Mukherjee, Pratibha Patil and ex-Vice President Hamid Ansari attended the event. Leaders like Sharad Yadav, Sitaram Yechuri, Satish Mishra, Ram Gopal Yadav, Kanimori and Dinesh Trivedi were also in attendance. However, top leaders like Sharad Pawar, Mamata Banerjee and Mayawati gave a miss to Rahul Gandhi's iftar party. Former Congress President Sonia Gandhi had hosted the last iftar party in 2015. On to some more developments, Congress President Rahul Gandhi has once again targeted the 4 years of Modi government. At a press conference in Mumbai on Wednesday, the Congress President said that a grand alliance of opposition parties led by Congress will be able to wipe out BJP in the 2019 polls. Responding to Rahul Gandhi's BJP leaders, Shahnawaz Hussain said that the people of the country are very happy with NDA government's achievements in the last 4 years and they have full faith in Prime Minister Modi's governance.
जो महागठबंधन है ये एक देश में सेंटिमेंट है ये पूरा का पूरा विपक्ष जो है ये प्रधानमंत्री बीजेपी और आरएसएस के खिलाफ खड़ा हो रहा है और ये सेंटिमेंट सिर्फ राजनीतिक लोगों में नहीं है ये जनता में है और ये सवाल जनता के अंदर भी है कि जिस प्रकार से प्रधानमंत्री जी बीजेपी हिंदुस्तान के कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन पर हिंदुस्तान के इंस्टीट्यूशंस पर आक्रमण कर रहे हैं इसको रोकने की ज़रूरत है और इस एक्सप्रेशन को इस आवाज़ को कांग्रेस पार्टी जोड़ने का काम कर रही है और बाकी पार्टियां भी इसमें लगी हुई हैं
उनको मालूम होना चाहिए कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी जब लोकसभा के चुनाव में जाएगी तो नरेंद्र मोदी जी को प्रधानमंत्री बनाने के लिए देश की जनता वोट डालने आएगी और हम मध्य प्रदेश छत्तीसगढ़ राजस्थान भी जीतेंगे हमारी सबसे बड़ी ताकत राहुल गांधी अगर समझते हैं कि बीजेपी की ताकत क्या है तो उनको मालूम होना चाहिए हमारी सबसे बड़ी ताकत नरेंद्र मोदी हैं और विपक्ष की सबसे बड़ी कमज़ोरी राहुल गांधी हैं राहुल गांधी जी को समझ लेना चाहिए कि भारतीय जनता पार्टी के नेता नरेंद्र मोदी से देश की जनता प्यार करती है और देश के लोग उन पर भरोसा करते हैं इसलिए ऐसा ख्याली पुलाव वो बनाते रहें कि मध्य प्रदेश छत्तीसगढ़ राजस्थान में वो हमें हरा लेंगे और 2019 में हमें हरा लेंगे ये सपना उनका कभी पूरा होने वाला नहीं है
And now the weather news. Air quality in the national capital and surrounding areas worsened as pollution levels in Delhi spiked again. The air quality in Delhi deteriorated beyond the severe level because of the ground level dust storm which increased coarser particles in the air according to the Central Pollution Control Board data showed that PM10 level was beyond severe at 778 in Delhi NCR area and 824 in Delhi particularly, leading to hazy conditions and limiting visibility.
अभी स्थिति बनी है वो एंटी साइक्लोनिक जो जो हवा है जो विंड है जो राजस्थान हरियाणा और पंजाब से दिल्ली की तरफ बढ़ रहा है और दिल्ली में पहुंचा है उसके कारण ये समस्या उठी है और साथ ही साथ दिल्ली के अंदर जो अपना डस्ट प्रोडक्शन है वो भी इस पूरे के पूरे चीज़ को स्पाइक कर दे रहा है तो दिल्ली का अपना लोकल डस्ट प्रॉब्लम और बाकी का जो एंटी साइक्लोनिक विंड के कारण डस्ट प्रॉब्लम है जिसके कारण एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स लगभग 600 से 900 के बीच में पिछले 12 घंटे में पिछले 18 घंटे में के रेंज में रहा है जो कि एक बहुत ही एक्सट्रीम है
Over 3,500 families have been rendered homeless in Tripura as heavy rains hit the state during the past 24 hours. Over 500 families have been evacuated to 6 relief camps in West Tripura's Sadar subdivision as their homes were submerged by water. Agartala received 86 mm of rainfall over the past 24 hours, while the highest rainfall of 172.6 mm was recorded in Sabroom in South District. The Assam Agartala National Highway, considered lifeline of the state, was opened for vehicular movement after clearing debris late Tuesday night. Torrential rainfall in Manipur and Mizoram has caused landslides and flash floods in several parts of the state. Rescue operations are currently going on. Vehicular movement along the Imphal Jiribam National Highway has been hampered. Flood waters have affected normal life in Imphal East and West. Meanwhile, several areas of Upper Assam and Barak Valley are also flooded. Water has also covered some stretch of National Highway 37, the highway linking Upper Assam and Guwahati. Around 700 to 800 meters of the National Highway in Lotabari area is submerged. In Karimganj, flood waters have inundated several localities. The SDRF team has launched rescue operations. And the United States government has approved a deal to sell the Indian military 6 AH-64E Apache attack helicopters for $930 million. The agreement has been passed to the U.S. Congress for approval. The approval concerns a direct sale of finished products from U.S. manufacturers. The order of 6 helicopters is in addition to an order of 22 Apache helicopters India placed in September 2015. Deliveries of the initial helicopters are scheduled to begin in 2019. In addition to the aircraft, the contract includes night vision sensors, GPS guidance, and hundreds of anti-armor and air-to-air missiles. The U.S. State Department said that the choppers will provide an increase in India's defensive capability to counter ground armored threats. And getting to the sports news now, Afghanistan is all set to make its debut in international cricket on Thursday. In a historic match, Afghanistan will take on world number one test team India at the Chinnaswamy Stadium in Bengaluru. With this match, Afghanistan will join the club of nations playing test cricket as the 12th member. Team India will be led by Ajinkya Rahane in the absence of skipper Virat Kohli. Afghanistan got the status of test playing nation in 2017 after joining International Cricket Council in 2001. Union Minister of State for Youth, Sports and Information and Broadcasting, Jayawardhan Singh Rathor, as well as Dr. Abdullah Abdullah, Chief Executive of Afghanistan, will be present as the chief guest in Bengaluru. India has played a crucial role in development of cricket in Afghanistan. Afghan players received training and coaching from Indian coach in their formative years. India had also helped the construction of cricket stadiums and grounds in Afghanistan, including one in Kandahar. And that's all we have for you in this edition of News Tonight. For more news and updates, keep watching Rajya Sabha Television.